Welcome everybody, undead or living, to this creepy video. It's October, and you know what that means, right? Pumpkin spice at Starbucks. In all seriousness, it is the spookiest time of year with Halloween on our doorsteps. Of course, as the title suggests, we'll be looking at a shelved anime project involving magical girls, pajamas, and Seattle. If you don't know, I was born and raised in Seattle, so there may be some bias here. Speaking of Seattle, there's an annual anime convention where this story starts at SakuraCon. In 2017, the convention committee would invite many guests, such as English voice actors Johnny Young Bosch and Matthew Mercer, anime legends like Urobuchi Gen and Hiroshi Nagahama, and the one we'll be focusing on in this video, Yasuhiro Irie. Starting out at Sunrise, Irie would be an animator on several series before moving on to doing key animation. You may recognize some names, such as Cowboy Bebop and Revolutionary Girl Utena. Okay, so when I went to grab this shot, I kept being reminded of something. The shot of two characters looking back on a zoom resonated with me, as if I saw it before. It wasn't until editing that I realized it is from Haruhi's opening. Is it a reference? Is it a shoutout? Or is it just something other anime openings have done repeatedly? I don't know, but I wanted to share this finding because I thought it was cool. Anyway, back to the video! He would eventually go on to direct Fullmetal Alchemist Brotherhood, which is probably what he is best known for, but would also do Nogizaka Haruka Secrets and Code Breaker. At his panel at SakuraCon, he asked for several attendees to model for a short animation done by him, which he would present on the last day of the event. While most would leave the convention soon after, Irie took his time in Seattle for research on the city's history and architecture. This was for the next issue of his original manga, Halloween Pajama. Oh yeah, he's a mangaka as well. So, what is Halloween Pajama? Well, there's a funny story of how it originated. Imagine this. Back in 2013, Yasuhiro Irie finishes working on Code Breaker and falls asleep at his desk. In his slumber, he dreams of a young lady floating above a city who transforms into a magical girl with a pumpkin head. He hurriedly wakes up to write down his idea and illustrates what would become Halloween Pajama. Sprouting from this concept would be a spooky tale following Jackie Ron, a young girl dreaming the same thing each night, herself floating above an upside-down city. One night, she ventures into the city and runs into a ghost that grants her powers as the magical girl, Halloween Pajama. Together, they must exorcise evil spirits and the witch of Halloween by Hallow's Eve, otherwise, their lives will be at stake. Irie would publish 6 volumes of his manga independently as a passion project between animating and directing different series throughout the years, but there would be a couple one-shot stories of additional tales, one such being the characters visiting the Emerald City, not in Oz, but Seattle. It would be called The Dream Catcher. As you can probably assume, it focuses on the Native American artifact of the same name that serves to protect good dreams by catching nightmares. Quite appropriate with how the series came to be. It follows Jackie and Chloe's trip to Seattle where they learn about its history but encounter a vengeful spirit. A woman called Dreamcatcher appears to help the spirit move on, but they take a trip around Seattle as the ghost flees. Eventually, they catch it, solve its problem, and return to Japan. A typical one-off story, but that wasn't why I wanted to talk about it. One thing I love about it is that it features actual locations from Seattle. I never truly understood what it meant to see something you've been at before in movies and shows until now. I mean, there were shows set in Seattle like Grey's Anatomy and iCarly, but they only showed the Space Needle and used transition shots from LA. Still, recognizing these local spots is mesmerizing. Even more so that it is artwork with meticulous detail displaying the craft and dedication of Yasuhiro Irie. Many panels communicate the locations extremely well based on direction, as if you were going through the actual city alongside the characters. For example, they start out at the Northwest Tribal Art Shop and head to the Seattle Underground by running to the right, which is the direction they would head after leaving the store. The girls return to the hotel for the night and I was confused since there are none called Niano. Then I look around to find it is actually Miano located on 3rd Avenue. Not a hotel, but a nail salon and spa. Afterwards, when the ghost escapes into Chloe's body, we move to Pike Place Market, which is self-explanatory, and follow up the street to the intersection at 4th and Pine. You can see the detail Irie drew with a unique type of pavement on the road and other features like the clock and park area. The next stop is Kell's Bar, located in Post Alley. Although cramped, you can see the sign above the patio on the left with a window below and the doors on the right. After a kerfuffle with Halloween Pajama and Dreamcatcher, the ghost reunites with their lost love in front of these double doors. I am unsure of the location because I cannot find it, but given the context of a graffiti-run area, I presume we're still in Post Alley and possibly near the famous Gum Wall. Sadly, there is very little viewing area via Google Maps, so you know what that means. Time to get in my car and not drive to a crowded marketplace during a pandemic. Anyway, the last location is one I couldn't find initially, but I looked at the transition panel of Pike Place Market, turned around, and found Victor Steinbrück Park next to the Seattle Aquarium. Look, there's even the totem pole there. So it seems Irde mapped out the location of the characters, took pictures, and drew them based on the characters' movements in the story, possibly mirroring his own. The only thing that seems to be original are the graffiti and murals, which are actually references to backers from Kickstarter, who also make cameo appearances in the background. The doujinshi didn't come out by itself though, as it came with an announcement. On October 15th, 2017, Yasuhiro Irie began crowdfunding for an OVA of Halloween Pajama titled Halloween Pajama in Seattle. It would follow the same story as the manga, but feature additional scenes since Irie presumes the manga by itself would only be 10 minutes long. The new scenes would be a musical with the characters singing and dancing, because the first thing you think of when you hear musical is Seattle. We've been labeled a cultural garbage can for decades. I mean, since then we've had our music evolve into the likes of Jimi Hendrix, Nirvana, Macklemore, but those aren't really musicals. We do have the Paramount Theater though, so maybe it is fitting. On the plus side, he compared the animated musical portion being similar in nature to DreamWorks' The Prince of Egypt, and the music feeling of Wicked, which might stem from the fact that Seattle is known as the Emerald City. The short film would contain an opening and ending sequence, both 90 seconds long, and would be key animated by Irie himself, with in-betweens and paintings done through outsourcing. This is a huge feat and something people shouldn't overlook, because the last time Irie key animated something by himself, we got Soul Eater's first opening. Have you seen this masterpiece? He even animated some of the backgrounds! If he can make Seattle feel alive with his animations just like in Soul Eater, I could just die. Additionally, he mentions that the outsourcing would focus on raising young animators by giving them higher salaries. He understands the current climate for animators is difficult and does not want to deter them from their best work. As a result, the Kickstarter would be asking for the high price of 20 million yen. As you could surmise from the title of this video, things would not go according to plan. Irie's Kickstarter raised only a little over 6.5 million yen. Thus, he canceled it on December 5th of the same year. Regarding its failure, he cited that people weren't aware of Halloween Pajama outside of Japan, which hindered its funding. In an interview with Anime News Network, he compared successful Kickstarter projects to his based on recognition. Most infamously, Little Witch Academia, which got a second short film via Kickstarter because of its popularity and feedback worldwide when the animation was shared on YouTube and Crunchyroll, which eventually led to it getting its own TV series. In response to this, Irie released his series on Kindle worldwide in multiple languages, including English. Irie shelved the project for the foreseeable future, but still has hopes of turning his manga into a TV series, which was the initial goal of the whole project. If the OVA was successful, he could pitch it as a TV series from the manga volumes he penned since it has technically been finished, and the Dreamcatcher is a one-off story. Test animations and drawings should have been playing about this essay to see where he was going with it, especially the transformation sequence. While it was a work in progress, the final design would match the promo image that fans found similar to Soul Eater, which is a style touching his sensitive side. We can only imagine what the anime in Seattle as a backdrop could have been. A spectacle of wonder and amusement could have happened. Still, the one-shot manga is available on the Kickstarter for free in English and Japanese. The series is on Kindle in multiple languages, and Irie still hopes to return to it someday. Until then, he has been working on the Netflix anime series Eden, which released this year, and is currently going to direct Healer Girl at Studio 3Hz. So look forward to those. Hi everyone, Secret Revealer here. I want to say Happy Halloween to every single one of you, especially if you celebrate the holiday. Please stay safe out there, especially during this time. Now for a brief update. As you probably can see, I have not uploaded in a few months. I just want to say that my life has been in a constant state of hell, and I'm just trudging through it right now, so I apologize. I do expect to upload a couple videos soon, and I do expect to participate in Pause and Select's NoVid Challenge this year. I look forward to it. I just want to give this update to all of you because I feel people need answers, especially when nothing has appeared, so I apologize once again. So thank you for your support, and if you enjoyed this video, please leave a like or comment on the topic. Hopefully you learned something new from it, and see you in the next one. Poof, poof.